you can see total democracy and you can see a totally humanitarian philosophy in Beethoven's music. You know, how the main voice travels around the orchestra and how the other voices supports it and how this whole thing moves around, and this is how it should be in life, you know? This is how I should shut up and listen to the other. But I think, therefore, Beethoven is the perfect music for Divan.
If you look at the development of the symphonies and the way Beethoven writing and orchestrating, it's huge from the first to the ninth. You know, it's a huge thing. And if you think of the extreme way that this orchestra grew up in the last 10 years, starting from a small project of you know, students basically, and we all grew up. So that's the maturity that the orchestra evolved in the last 10 years. As parallel to the maturity of Beethoven, sort of how he evolves with the symphonies, you know, and it's quite nice to feel that.
We don't even get to meet these people, not to say even play, but we don't get to see these people from places like Syria, Lebanon. It's such an incredible experience to just meet them face to face, let alone play with them. So,
well, this idea of bringing together Arabs and Israelis, of course, is really, it's really nice and it's really attractive for people, and not attractive for some people, you know. But I mean, for me, I thought it's a great forum to do amazing music and at the same time be able to discuss the things that we care a lot about and that occupy a lot of our time and attention and life and actually dictate how we are as human beings.
Well, it's what I feel in general about playing with the Divan, that it has a greater significance beyond just any orchestra because of who we are and what we stand for. It gives it a whole meaning. Before coming to Divan, I was living in Israel, of course, and I had my world, which did not include any Arabs in it. I mean, there are people living in Israel, but I never had much contact with them. You know, in the beginning, before really meeting the Arabs, I was very scared of them because the only thing I knew about them is that they're terrorists and that they do terrible things to my people.
I mean, the standard view on both sides is that these people hate us, punked, and that's it, right? And you just don't understand what the other side is even thinking half the time, right? And you're not even used to thinking about the other side in any way as people. You just think of them as a side, right? As a flag, right? As an enemy. I think Divan has to show you, you know, it has to make you feel very intensely that these people, even though they are your enemy, that you want to feel positively about them. And I think that's what the Divan does.
Well, you know, if you look at his marking in the music, I mean, the fortissimo and the fortissimo, and they all have to be different. And he really stretches everything to a new extreme way. And I think it suits what this orchestra is about, because we try to go to the extreme in the dialogue. We try to go to new places in our imagination. And this orchestra creates a platform for us.
For me, actually, the experience of going to Ramallah was very, very strong, because I think that it was the first time that the orchestra actually performed in our region.
The plan was it will be the last concert if it takes place. You know, we said goodbye just in case it won't take place and we won't see each other.
We were in Jerusalem the night before, and the next day the diplomatic cars came to pick us up, and it was like a 20-minute drive, and we were in Ramallah. And it was amazing.
Very good, very good. You see, the impossible is much easier than the difficult.
I mean, here's a great composer that is so promising and all that, and he's losing his hearing, you know. And I mean, that's just a catastrophe for him personally. But he overcame that somehow. And in fact, the best music he wrote is when he was really deaf. So it gives us, a little hope in terms of the, maybe there is a possibility after all the suffering and humiliations and killings on both sides and the violence, that there is light at the end of the tunnel, so to speak, you know, and there is a possible that the human spirit eventually will succeed.
Real conflict. That's a good situation when it's calm, but now it's not in Israel. Now it's not. So I'm coming back to a state of war almost. But we have music. So most of my power is from music making. It's an escape from it, from reality sometimes.
Single rooms in hotels.
Serious.
I wish someday, you know, there is some sort of agreement, one state solution, two state solution, whatever, and the wall comes down, okay, and they sign an agreement for that, and we play in the ceremony. That's my dream for Divan. But everything starts with a dream. Single rooms.